Ladies and gentlemen, today we have gathered for our third Foundation Day lecture. The first Foundation Day lecture was delivered by Shri Kailash Satyarthi in 2015. Shri Kailash Satyarthi is a Nobel Peace Prize laureate and the founder of Bachpan Bachao Andolan. The second Foundation Day of our lecture was delivered by Honorable Justice D.K. Jain, President of National Consumer Disputes Redressal Commission in 2016. Today, the third Foundation Day lecture shall be delivered by His Excellency Shri Ramnath Kovind, the Honorable President of India and the Chief Guest for the evening. It is for the first time that His Excellency Shri Ramnath Kovind is visiting Odisha and our university.
National Law University Odisha has emerged as a leading destination for legal education in India, offering programs BA LLB, BBA LLB, LLM, and PhD. In order to create an environment to foster academic research, we have 17 research centers currently functioning. The objective of the university is not just to create a center of excellence in the field of legal education, but also to develop humane lawyers with integrity and contribute to the social justice mission of legal education. The university has earned a good reputation for its exceptional achievement, both at national and international levels, be it moot competitions, debates, literary activities, publications in quality journals, and various other extracurricular activities. Recently, National Law University Odisha has secured the runners-up position and the Best Memorial Award at the first edition of the Competition Commission of India, National Law University Delhi, National Moot Court Competition. Our university has also secured the runners-up position at the South Asia Rounds of the Price Media Law Moot Court Competition 2018 and has qualified for the World Rounds to be held in April at the University of Oxford. The university has also signed an MOU with the University of Geneva for the International Executive Course on Juvenile Justice to be held in July and October 2018. The university has also signed an MOU with the Indian Council of Medical Research for establishing a center for health and bioethics.
May I now request everyone to kindly stand as the dignitaries arrive into the auditorium. Everyone is requested to kindly stand as the dignitaries are arriving. May I now request Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Shri Krishna Deva Rao, to kindly deliver the welcome address.
Honorable President of India, Shri Ramnath Kovind, Honorable First Lady of India, Mrs. Savita Kovind, Honorable Chief Justice of India, Sri Justice Deepak Mishra, and our visitor, Madam Suprama Mishra, Honorable Governor of Odisha, Dr. S. C. Jameer, Honorable Chief Minister of Odisha, Sri Naveen Patnaik, Honorable Union Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, Sri Dharmendra Pradhan, Honorable Chief Justice of Orissa High Court, Sri Justice Vinit Saran, and our Chancellor, Madam Uma Saran, Honorable Sitting and Retired Judges of Orissa High Court, Senior Advocates and Members of Orissa Bar Association, my colleagues, students of the university, media persons, ladies and gentlemen. I am delighted to extend a very warm welcome to all of you on behalf of NLU Odisha family on this occasion of the third Foundation Day lecture. The idea of organizing Foundation Day lecture was originally conceived by our visitor, Honorable Justice Deepak Mishra, in 2014, and we started celebrating thereafter. Foundation Day marks a celebration of cherishing the foundational aspirations and contributions of all those who helped in establishing NLU Odisha. The university was established in the year 2008, and we started imparting legal education from 2009. The university offers 5-year integrated law program, master's degree and PhD. We started the first skills education in law in 2016, advanced vocational program in paralegal studies under the Barefoot Lawyers College with the support of University Grants Commission. NLU Odisha nurtures young minds and trains them to be humane lawyers to serve the society. Some of our students who studied in Ivy League law schools abroad always underscore its finest enabling academic ambience that facilitates learning. They say that they could learn and grow by just being there in the Ivy law schools. World-class infrastructure and sufficient resources, along with an enabling environment, goes a long way in the growth of self-motivated and bright young achievers. The outstanding work of the faculty is indispensable in inspiring the young minds to achieve more. NLUs are unique institutions in the sense that they have students from various parts of the country. National law universities are set up with the support of the respective high courts and state governments. We are grateful to the Honorable Chief Minister for all the support to enhance the quality legal education. Our students have been performing very well in literary and debating competitions and international and national moot court competitions. Our moot court team now will represent India in world round of prize media law moot court competition in Oxford next month. We have just signed an MOU with Geneva University to offer the first international executive course in juvenile justice from July 2018. And a new research center on health and bioethics will be set up in association with the Indian Council of Medical Research, New Delhi. In the years to come, we will put in more sincere efforts to enable the university to scale new heights of excellence. My best wishes to students and staff of the university. The sports festival, Viraj, and cultural festival will begin from tomorrow. Let me conclude by welcoming you all once again. Thank you. Jai Hind.
May I now request Honorable Justice Vinit Saran, Chief Justice of Odisha High Court and Chancellor, National Law University, Odisha, to kindly deliver his address.
Your Excellency, the President of India, Hon’ble Shri Ramnath Kovindji, and respected First Lady, Srimati Savita Kovindji. Your Excellency, the Governor of Odisha, Dr. S.C. Jameerji, Honorable Mr. Justice Deepak Mishra, Chief Justice of India and Visitor, National Law University, Odisha, and respected Madam Srimati Suprama Mishra, Honorable Chief Minister of Odisha, Shri Naveen Patnaik Ji, Honorable Minister of Union Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas and Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Shri Dharmendra Pradhan Ji, my esteemed brother judges of Odisha High Court present here, Vice Chancellor, Registrar and faculty members of National Law University, Odisha, members of the legal fraternity, distinguished invitees, my dear students, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to all of you. I am delighted to be here today amongst this magnificent gathering on the occasion of the third Foundation Day lecture of the National Law University, Odisha, where we are blessed to have such significant personalities of our country and our state. Today, we are really gratified by the distinguished presence of His Excellency the President of India and respected First Lady, His Excellency the Governor of Odisha, Hon’ble Chief Justice of India, Hon’ble Chief Minister of Odisha and Hon’ble Union Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, who have not only exalted the eminence of today's functions, but have also glorified this institution by their gracious presence. Being the Vice Chancellor of this university, I once again take the privilege to extend my hearty welcome for all to this university. Ladies and gentlemen, today this university is having its third Foundation Day lecture, which reminds us of its Foundation Day. The journey of National Law University Odisha from its temporary campus at Chahata in 2009 to its present Katajori campus in 2012 is one phase of the development of this university. The succeeding years from 2012 to 2018 is a second phase of development where we have established a reputation amongst the national universities in India. All these efforts were successful due to the combined efforts made by all of us, including the support from the state government. In a span of 9 years, the university has gained reputation in making commendable contribution in the field of legal education. National Law University Odisha has taken its course to develop, and it is still evolving, and I hope it will march forward to greater heights. We all know that a university is simply bricks, and is not simply bricks and mortar. It is toil, sweat, sleepless nights, midnight lamps, and so much more. No doubt this university has developed such a scenic and admirable campus, but let us not today just think in terms of building infrastructure and facilities. Ladies and gentlemen, so far as my knowledge goes, and what I have seen in the growth and development of the university over the last 2 years, National University Odisha has made a name not only in the national sphere, but also in the international arena. Today, National University Odisha stands high and competent like any other law school in the metropolitan city of a country. The fact that students from various states in the country come to study here makes the experience of students, teachers and staff rich and diverse in their culture and ethics. They all learn and grow from each other's widespread cultural knowledge, and thus National University Odisha is known for its vibrant culture. The university is making progress in imparting quality legal education in India. The students are also doing well in moot court competitions around the world. Lawyers play a vital role in making a constitution a living reality, and institutions like national universities in India are playing a pivotal role in producing talented lawyers and professional legal professionals. Positive thoughts are the need of the day. If each one of us sitting here contributes towards the vision, prosperity and success and development of this university, it will not be long time to reach the peak in the true sense of the term. For all of us, today is a day of remembrance, a day to honor, a day to celebrate what we have achieved over the past few years, and a day to look forward to what is yet to come and to be achieved. I hope and strongly believe that this institution will achieve the heights of glorious success. Thank you all very much.
May I now request Honorable Justice Vineet Saran, Chief Justice, Odisha High Court, and Chancellor of National Law University, Odisha, to felicitate Honorable President of India, His Excellency, Shri Ramnath Kovind. May I now request Hon’ble Vice Chancellor, National Law University, Odisha, to felicitate Hon’ble First Lady of India, Srimati Savita Kovind. May I now request Hon’ble Vice Chancellor, National Law University, Odisha, to felicitate Hon’ble Governor of Odisha, His Excellency Dr. S.C. Jamil. May I now request Hon’ble Justice Vineet Saran, Chief Justice of Odisha High Court and Chancellor, National Law University, Odisha, to felicitate Hon’ble Justice Deepak Mishra, Chief Justice of India and Visitor, National Law University, Odisha. May I now request Hon’ble Vice Chancellor, National Law University, Odisha, to felicitate Hon’ble Chief Minister of Odisha, Shri Naveen Patnaik. May I now request Hon’ble Vice Chancellor, National Law University, Odisha, to felicitate Hon’ble Union Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, Shri Dharmendra Pradhan.
May I now request Hon’ble Justice Deepak Mishra, Chief Justice of India and Visitor, National Law University, Odisha, to kindly deliver his address.
His Excellency, Shri Ramnath Kovind, Honorable the President of India, Srimati Savita Kovind, respected the First Lady of the country, Dr. S. A. Jamil, Honorable the Governor of Odisha, Sri Naveen Patnaik, Honorable the Chief Minister of Odisha, Sri Dharmendra Pradhan, Honorable Union Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, Sri Justice Vineet Saran, Honorable the Chief Justice of Odisha High Court and Chancellor of National Law University, Odisha, Honorable sitting and former judges of the High Court of Odisha, Professor Sri Krishnadev Rao, Vice Chancellor of National Law University, Odisha, Mr. S.P. Mishra, an Advocate General for State of Odisha, members of the faculty, dear students, friends from the electronic and print media, ladies and gentlemen. It's my duty to tell you, possibly you don't know. In a dinner, an idea got into my head that I must, as the visitor of this university, request His Excellency to address the students of National Law University. The moment I told that there is a group of students and groups of students and students will be assembling to listen to him with eagerness, he immediately said, I would like to be amongst the students, and that is how he is here with us. And as the visitor, I have to acknowledge, apart from formal thanks that shall be rendered afterwards, I express my heartfelt thanks to Your Excellency. Today, we are celebrating the Foundation Day. When I ask myself, were you there when the foundation stone was laid? You are not there. The people who will get into this university afterwards, they will not be there. But still, the Foundation Day has to be celebrated as a mark of remembrance, recapitulation, and also to retrospect, introspect, and also see what we can do in the future. I'm reminded of one thing. When there is a Foundation Day, there's a concept of foundation stone. The stone has lost its identity. It has been converted into a university where we are. For all of you who permit me, I'll give a name today to all the students. When you graduate from this university, you shall be the cornerstone of the nation to fight for the idea of liberty, the virtue of equality, and the cherished dreams of millions to efface tears from their eyes. And that is why you shall become the cornerstones of liberty, equality, and justice to make the people accessible to said norms in a court of law, maybe in a corporate form to somebody else, or maybe somewhere else in an academy where we train students. And that is what is the importance of a Foundation Day. I'm reminded of a saying by Gordon B. Hinckley, who said very nice things about students. You and the building. You can't build a great building with a meek foundation. You have to have solid foundation if you are going to build a strong superstructure. You are our superstructures. And therefore, when the foundation stone was laid, whoever was in charge of the university, maybe I came afterwards, somebody will come after me. They all shall dream of you, superstructures who are here, who shall be here. The word foundation, I would like to suggest, is the plinth of all the students who are studying today, who have studied earlier, and who will be coming. The generation doesn't matter. It's the institution that matters. It's the young souls who are present here and who are studied here, who are yet to come, shall matter. To build the infrastructure to save this great nation. Somebody talked to me the other day, and he said, it's very difficult to understand Albert Einstein's theory of relativity. I said, yes, we are not physicists. We are not great scientists that we can understand Einstein, but what Albert Einstein told about the studies meant for the young is very easy to understand. A great pleasure to appreciate, and it's really ecstasy to be with Einstein. He said, and I quote, never regard your study as a duty, but as the opportunity to learn. It's never a duty, it's an opportunity. Father of the nation at the sword said in the same tone and tenor that you are the young, you are the builders, you are the founders, in a different way. I'm not quoting Mahatma Gandhi for the present, I'm giving you the idea. Now I'll make a distinction between a doctor's profession and a lawyer's profession. When a doctor treats a person as a physician or as a surgeon or a neurosurgeon, he cures an individual. In the process, possibly he helps the family, maybe a part of the collective. But as lawyers, you young people, young boys and girls, when you become lawyers, and when you fight for liberty, when you fight for equality, you fight for justice, you fight for choice of an individual, there is no individual, there is no group, there is no part of the collective, it is for the whole, the entire collective. You are the torch bearers, the laser beams for the collective. We had a poem that was taught to us in school. I didn't agree with the poem and I don't still agree. The poet said, just two lines. Please listen carefully. Fame is a food that dead men eat. Fame is a food that dead men eat. I have no stomach for that kind of meat. I don't agree with these two lines, and I would suggest to you, do not, for God's sake, ever agree with this poem, with this utterance. On the contrary, I have two lines to suggest. What is this life without fame? What is this life without fame? What is this light without flame? If you have a life without fame, it's no life. If you have a light without flame, that's no light. Therefore, my young friends, young Jarsian law, please think of fame in your mind, reputation in your mind when you become lawyers. Cultivate yourself. I expect you should lead and fight for your reputation and to take a place on this Foundation Day to become a successful law graduate in times to come. And if you have the time, if you have the inclination, if you have the desire, please come on the Foundation Day to hear a lecture, and if possible, you can call me. If I demit my office and if I'm available, I'll be your companion. Thank you.
May I now request His Excellency Shri Ramnath Kovind, Hon’ble President of India and the chief guest for the evening, to kindly deliver the Foundation Day address.
Chief Justice of India and visitor, National Law University, Odisha, Shri Justice Deepak Mishraji, Governor of Odisha, Dr. S.C. Jamirji, Chief Minister of Odisha, Shri Naveen Patnaikji, Union Minister for Petroleum and Natural Gas, Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Shri Dharmendra Pradhanji, Chief Justice of Odisha High Court and Chancellor, National Law University, Odisha, Sri Justice Vineet Saranji, Vice Chancellor, National Law University, Odisha, Professor Sri Krishna Deva Raoji, distinguished guests, dear students, ladies and gentlemen. Since the Honorable Chief Justice of India happens to be the visitor of this university, so I thought it proper to share with you that the correct pronunciation of his name is Chief Justice Deepak Mishra, and not Chief Justice Deepak Mishra. I have shared this viewpoint only to tell you, because he happens to be well connected with your university. Friends, I am glad to be here for the third Foundation Day lecture of the National Law University, Odisha. My greetings to all of you on this auspicious Foundation Day. This is one of 19 national law schools in our country, first such institution having been founded in 1986 as the National Law School of India, Bangalore. Over the past three decades, this cohort of law universities has revolutionized legal education in India. The National Law University Odisha is one of the younger and more dynamic members of this group. Set up a decade ago, in 2008, it builds on the legacy of several legal luminaries of this state, beginning with the pioneering advocate and nation builder Madhusudan Das, and extending to the current Chief Justice of India, Justice Deepak Mishra. This institution has become a major center for legal education in not just Odisha, but across our country. It is recognized as a center of excellence, attracting students from, I have been told, 25 of India's 29 states. It can be said that today I have the privilege of addressing rather many India. The modernization of the legal profession has kept pace with the rise in opportunities for law graduates and young lawyers. While litigation in the courtroom remains at the core of legal practice, a law graduate today finds many avenues open to him or her that were simply not available to previous generations. As our economy has grown, the legal profession too has expanded. Commercial and business law have become more important, complex, and intellectually stimulating. If this is true domestically, it is also true internationally. Trade and commerce, international agreements, and even the craft of diplomacy increasingly turn to lawyers and legal minds for negotiations and skilled drafting of texts. Arbitration and the globalization of legal services through mechanisms such as outsourcing have also linked today's lawyers with the rest of our planet. It is on legal professionals that we depend to not merely make sense of the world as it is, but also the world as it is becoming. This is especially true for technology law, often with technology outpacing changes in the law. As a result, lawyers are called upon to develop regulatory frameworks for and in extremely dynamic and evolving technological environments. This has been true to cyberspace and for internet law. In the years ahead, legal teaching institutions as well as practitioners will have to meet many more such challenges. They will have to create rules and legal frameworks for outer space, for the fourth industrial revolution, and for artificial intelligence too. They will have to write laws for new equations between humans and machines, whether driverless cars or innovations in agriculture and medicines. For the legal students of today, such as the bright boys and girls of this institution, this opens up almost limitless opportunities. Your training and skills can leave an impact on a wider variety of human endeavors and sectors than was possible in the case of your predecessors. It is for legal education institutions to enhance this multidisciplinary as well as interdisciplinary approach of law and of the legal profession. Here, I am happy to note that the National Law University of Odisha is at the frontier of legal education and is equipping its students in new fields and introducing them to new possibilities. Using the Government of India's Global Initiative for Academic Networks or GYAN program, this university has offered over the past year courses in international e-commerce law and in corporate governance in India. These have involved guest faculty from the United States and Singapore also. I am also glad to note the curriculum of the university is socially relevant, with a focus on development of an entrepreneurial and innovative mindset. The clinical course on legal aid and PIL, as well as law and entrepreneurship course, stands testimony to this. Set up in 2015, the Distance Education Center of National Law University Odisha is, I understand, developing distance education and massive open online courses under Swayam. This is an initiative of the Government of India to provide opportunities for lifelong learning. I have been told that from July this year, a distance education and online course on child rights, developed with the support of UNICEF, will be introduced. I commend this effort. For all its advances, at its roots, the legal profession has a simple aspiration for the lawyer to be a voice for the voiceless and to bring justice to the most deprived. To secure the universal and inalienable rights of every child is an aspiration that makes the legal profession just so meaningful. Ladies and gentlemen, over the years, our understanding of law and its applications has become larger as well as more sophisticated. The nuances of privacy and of individual choice, the deeper integration of the concept of rights and responsibilities, and the search for the happy mean between space and autonomy for innovation and regulation for the greater common good in fields such as biotechnology and communication technology are all examples. Yet, in all this, are we paying enough attention to issues of legal infrastructure and access to justice, especially for ordinary citizens? I have spoken earlier of the need to enhance legal literacy and simplify legal rules, as well as for the quick availability of certified translated copies of high court judgments in the local language of the state or region. All these will take justice closer to the people. I am happy to learn that some high courts have responded to this positively. But while the judicial system has its responsibilities, so does the lawyer community, a community to which such students of this institution will soon belong. An advocate is a law officer of the court. He or she has a responsibility to the client, but also a duty to assist the court in delivery of justice. Our legal system has a reputation for being expensive and for being prone to delays. The use and abuse of the instrument of adjournments is often done by advocates who see adjournment as a tactic to slow down proceedings rather than a response to a genuine emergency. This adds to the cost of obtaining justice for litigant. It would be travesty of our republican ethic if a poor person did not get the same access to the law as a rich person. Unfortunately, in practice, this is happening. These are issues for the emerging generation of lawyers, including those studying at this institution, to ponder and to rectify in the course of their careers. The opportunities and rewards of this profession, both intellectual and financial, are enormous, and this is welcome. But a good legal professional is not just somebody with a mind, he or she is also somebody with a heart. Dear students, on this auspicious occasion of Founding Day, I would rather appeal to all of you to take a pledge. Whenever you start your legal career, please do whatever you can with a sense to pay back to the society. May the National Law University, Odisha, shape fine minds, and may it nurture warm hearts. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Members of Odisha Bar Association, distinguished guests, students, members of media, members of the National University Odisha family. It is a great privilege and honor to present a vote of thanks in this historic occasion. I, on behalf of myself and on behalf of the National University Odisha family, convey deep regards and hearty thanks to the Honorable President of India for delivering the third Foundation Day lecture. I convey my warm gratitude to the Honorable First Lady of India, Shri Sarita Kovind, for her invitation. I also convey my deep gratitude and thanks to Honorable Doctor of Odisha, Doctor S. C. Jamil, Honorable Chief Minister of Odisha, Shri Ravi Patnaik, and Honorable Union Minister of Odisha, Shri Kovind. I also
persons.
Jaldi kar. Jaldi.